Hello there. So let's start this hangout about campus Wi-Fi in MENA. So I'm Hisham Yehia. I'm from the infrastructure and access team. We try to bring more people online in the Middle East and North Africa. And this will be done by reducing access barriers and making the internet relevant and affordable for people. So basically, we have several initiatives and projects in MENA with a main focus on universities and higher education in general. So we believe that internet connectivity is no longer a luxury, and it will it allows students and professors to access information, share knowledge, and create an environment that makes learning more meaningful. Campus Wi-Fi is one of these initiatives. Let me start by showing you some of the main access internet access challenges inside inside the campus. The accessibility, which means we need to have access to the internet. It can be wireless access or wired access. Sometimes in universities we have like labs with desktop computers where we can have access to the internet. But wireless access is more relevant because now we have smartphones and laptops. The availability is about having an always-on connectivity, which means anytime you would like to go to the internet, make some web browsing, or use Google Apps to send email, we would like to be always on and to have the connectivity all the time. Also, quality of service, QS, is one of the major and important aspects of campus internet access. Because sometimes we do have access points or wireless coverage inside the campus, but with a poor quality of service, so that it can be impossible even to send an email. And finally, security is important. Security and confidentiality of the information in order to send emails and save documents on the cloud without any security issue. Now let's have a look on the campus internet access framework. So when we talk with IT admins of universities and faculties in the Middle East and North Africa, sometimes wireless connectivity is just perceived as deploying access points, and that's all. In fact, there are four important aspects for any internet access connectivity inside the campus. The first one is the last mile aspect, which means the wireless coverage or the wired connectivity, bandwidth management, and quality of service and security. The second aspect is the backhauling. So backhauling is the connectivity between the different campuses and the different buildings. So what we can see is that usually the IP connectivity or the internet connectivity is provided to one building in a university, and then all of the buildings will be connected to this central location where we have the internet gateway or the main router. So it is important to have a good backhauling or inter-site, inter-campus network to support the traffic that will be generated by the different campuses or the different buildings. Also, operations and maintenance is one important aspect here. What happens if one access point or the main router in the central IT location is down? So we need to have an IT help desk with a ticketing system in order to escalate any major problem. Also, IT admins have to deploy network monitoring tools to make sure that all the devices are working properly. The final aspect is the optimization. This is a continuous task done by the IT admins to optimize the current infrastructure of the internet inside the campus. So in the access and infrastructure team, we have different projects to cover these four main aspects. And now I will talk about the campus Wi-Fi that will cover more the last mile aspects of the internet access framework. So basically, this is the campus Wi-Fi. We have the access points that can be deployed. This is the back end or the access controller. So the access controller will provide several functions important to authenticate the users and also to authorize the users to use specific services inside the campus. So this access controller is basically a firewall that will filter all of the traffic. The users will connect to the access points with an open SSID without any encryption. The access controller will intercept the traffic, and the user will be redirected to a captive portal to enter his username and password. And once the user is authenticated, he will be able to have full connectivity to the internet. So this is the first function, which is the firewall. Now we have a triple A. A triple A is an authentication, authorization, and accounting server. So here we would like to authenticate the users and give access to the internet to the students and the staff of the faculty, and not for everyone. So that's why we will have an integration between this access controller and Google OAuth API. So the idea here is to have what we call the federated authentication. So instead of having one username and password to have access to the internet, and then having a second login and password to connect to the mailbox and Google Apps, we can have only one login and password, which is the Google identity, the Google Apps account, to access all of the services that will be provided by the faculty or the university. So also we have the DHCP to provide dynamic IP addresses to the terminals, and the captive portal, of course, to use your Google Apps login and password to connect. And finally, a web caching. So the web caching is mainly a server that will download the most popular websites and videos in order to serve the users. So this the web caching will basically optimize the web traffic by caching the most popular content on the access controller. So these are the main features supported by campus Wi-Fi: federated authentication and single sign-on. So using your Google Apps identity, you'll be able to access the internet, your mailbox, and all of the services provided by the university. This is radio agnostic, which means the access controller can be deployed with any type of access points from any manufacturer. And we have the traffic shaping capabilities, which means the IT admin will be able to make some policies to give priority to the most important traffic. So now let me share with you a video about campus Wi-Fi. So basically, you'll be able to access the Wi-Fi access point without any encryption or username or password. When you try to log in or to browse on the internet, you will be redirected to a captive portal. You will be prompted to enter your username and password, which is the Google identity. And then you will have access to the internet using your Google identity. So this is how the IT admin of the faculty or the university will be able to authenticate and authorize the user. So now we have, we will launch a pilot in one of the universities in the region. It's University of Marrakesh. The pilot will be, will start deployment by end of this year. We have all of the subcontractors and the system integrator on site in Marrakesh. Ready for deployment. We will evaluate the pilot during the next 2 months, and we would like and would be happy to support other universities to deploy the same kind of solution. So if you think that in your university or faculty there's a potential to deploy this kind of solution, don't hesitate to contact me, and we will be in touch with your IT, the IT admin of the university, to see how can we deploy this kind of solution in your university. Thank you.